the art feed routine vlog. So today we're going to be making Spring's feed, Bella's feed and Tex's feed, and we're just going to kind of show you what it contains and what it does to them. Ruby is filming right now, but I'll be filming when she makes Tex's feeds, and then I'll also be helping explain because girl's not there. Anyway, oh, I've got the feed bowls. I actually forgot the feed bowls. Okay, come then guys, let's go get the feed bowls. So, we officially got the bowls. I don't know how I forgot the bowls. But yeah, these are our feed bins, all these four bins, then that's our stuff. But yeah, anyway, we're going to start off with this bin here. So this is our top spec light balancer. Spring's been having this since about November, December. So we just give a little spring pull, as she's a little bit plump. And this just helps with like all the natural oils and stuff like that. I don't know all the technical stuff, guys, don't ask me. But yeah, my mum buys it. So yeah, anyway. Next we've got the Devil's Claw. This is a joint supplement that helps with joints. Excuse the state of me, by the way, guys. I've just been in the pool and I'm freezing to death, honestly. But yeah, it's really cold in here, actually. But yeah, we just put 20ml in each one. So yeah. And then we're going to go in with this electrolytes powder. This is a sample one. It came with my turmeric. From Equine America. So this is just a little sample. We've just been using it more in her dinner. Just a little bit, just a little sprinkle, so that it helps her stay hydrated. And yeah, so we just kind of put a little sprinkle in her dinner. As you know, I've got to water it down quite a bit. But yeah, just a little bit, just to thingy. But this is the Apple Light Powder. Replenish lots of. Wait, hold on. Replenishes lost electrolytes after exercise. So say like after her exercise, she'll get this. But yeah, next we're gonna do a sprinkle of honey nuts in each feed. Just like that. That's just kind of more for flavoring. It's not really for like anything else. But yeah, next we're gonna go in with this stinky stuff. Let's get a quick little close up. So this is stinky stuff. This it's quite expensive, but it's definitely really good. So we've been using this for about a week or two now. This is to help with scurf. Anyway, this is to help with scurf and itchiness and stuff like that. It's quite expensive, but it's definitely worth it. And they have a sale on right now. I probably put a bit too much in, but it doesn't really matter. Gets rid of as much scurf as we can. I don't think there's an overdosage, I'm sure, but you know, that's not that much. But yeah, normally you're meant to do 20ml, but I just done like 30ml, but you know. Anyway, that measuring cup is to figure it out so it's precise, even though I'm not very precise. But yeah, moving on to the bin with lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of supplements. Anyway, so I'm going to take you through the turmerics we got. We got two, but we're kind of mixing between the two because they're both different ones. So this one is turmeric gold. This is from Global Herbs. This one is £16.50 and I definitely think it's very good. Today I'm going to be using the other turmeric though. I just flip and swap. This is the turmeric extra. This is from Equine America. I absolutely love this stuff. This turmeric is to help with their joints and stuff like that. So yeah, let's quickly put it in. So this one, definitely you need a lot more. So apparently you're meant to do a whole scoop. So yeah. If I can get the lid open. I'm so bad at opening lids though. Right, so this is the scoop. It's quite a big scoop actually. And you just got to do one in each feed. I know it looks like quite a bit, but I promise. It's gonna be okay. But yeah, that's supplement. Next we're gonna go in with the Agnus Castus. I know it's in a garlic tub, guys. Do not judge, I promise.
But it was in a bag.
Yeah, it was in a bag, but we out the bag because it was one that didn't ring seal. So yeah, so this is just to help her when she's kind of like in season, moody and stuff like that. It does stuff, but like it doesn't do, like it's not fully thingy.
Doesn't do as much as you'd hope it would.
Yeah, but it's still really good and it takes off the edge. So yeah, next we're gonna go with garlic. This is flavour and also like keeping flies away and stuff. She gets her garlic lick as well every now and then to keep away the flies. So yeah, this is just garlic from Gold Label. This is really good. Right, next we're gonna use some chaff. Right, this is the Denji blue laminitis chaff. I'm pretty sure one low sugar one. This is the dark blue one. But yeah, I definitely think this is really good because in December, I think it was, before she had laminitis. No, January. Before she had laminitis because she kept on going lame and putting all her hooves. So we bought that. But she's not actually got laminitis, guys. Didn't actually have it, but we just took safety precaution and bought some low sugar chaff. But yeah, anyway, that's pretty much spring's feeds. It's a bit boring really, but there is a lot of supplements. But yeah, she definitely, so all these supplements, they help all different things and stuff like that. So yeah, anyway. Right, anyway, so next one, Bella's feeds. Bella literally has a sprinkle of chaff, but I'm just going to explain why she only has that much and why she has it. So this is Happy with chaff. She has it as just a little kind of filler. She doesn't have too much of it because otherwise she does gain weight quite easily. She does lose it quite quickly as well, but she definitely gains it quite quickly. So she just has a little sprinkle of chaff. Let's get close up. Just like that size. That's just kind of normal feed for her. This one might need a little bit more actually, but she just has about that much, just so she doesn't get too plump. So yeah, as Shetlands are quite prone to laminitis. And then we just give it a little water. Excuse the toilet in the background, guys. Sorry.
So aesthetic.
I know, for real. I thought it's not that good, but you know, it's fine, we live. So I just water it down just so it's not like dry chaff and it's not all like yucky. So just mix it and then I'm going to put it in the breakfast bin. Oh, I've just got chaffy hands now.
Chaffy hands.
Chaff. Right, and next I'm going to put some water in her dinner. So she just has a little bit just so it's not plain dry chaff. But yeah, that's more just kind of keep her going, fill her up and stuff like that.
She gets hay,
she gets grass. She's out on full day turnout and she's also has hay all night. She has a huge hay net. It's nearly the size of Spring's. Actually I don't think that's possible.
No.
But yeah, anyway, next we're gonna go on to Tex, but we're gonna do his a little bit later, so yeah. Right, guys, so we're just coming back in so that Ruby can finish off the feeds. Right, so hold on, let me show you the mustache. It has pretty much fully dissolved.
So he gets a scoop of cushion pro because he's got cushion, so this just helps with it. He normally gets garlic, but we've run out.
Yeah.
So we've had to order.
The garlic's to cover up the cushion pro, by the way, guys. He has one scoop in each feed.
In each feed, yeah.
And then he has all that stuff in the bins and a bit of chaff. What chaff is it? Is it Happy Hoof? Let me have a look. Let's have a look, guys. Yeah, that's Happy Hoof. So he has Happy Hoof, chaff. And then he has Pink Mash by Keyflow, is that? Is that the brand, Keyflow?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then...
So he has half of it in his breakfast
and then he has a three quarters in his dinner. So yeah, wait, does he have these ones as well or is it just that?
Just them.
Why has he got so many supplements?
Well, he had she's got Firm Up, so I'm guessing he had one of those.
Yeah,
So there's loads of different supplements. Yeah, Ruby's just going to mix them. There's loads of different supplements for different things, if you didn't know that. But yeah, look at Bella's little rider. I'm actually obsessed with it. It's so cute. It's really dusty, but there's loads of spider webs on it, so I'm not touching it. But yeah, that's kind of his dinners and breakfast. But yeah. It's looking so scrumptious.
Would you eat it?
No.
Okay.
But yeah.
Ruby's just making that.
Not my little style, but you know.
This is like really tight and scary. Like, I suppose if there was a rat, we'd be able to run out of here because you just wouldn't, would you? Yeah, you just wouldn't be able to really run out, would you? Because it's a bit too slim.
I swear to God, a rat is there. Like, imagine if it just jumped out at you and it, like, you wouldn't be able to get out because there's stuff everywhere. And it's also a really slim cupboard. Oh, like, God, I got it.
Right.
They're his feeds. And then, yeah, that's pretty much it for it today. And then one of them goes in the breakfast bin. And then one of them goes in the, in his wheelbarrow for his dinner. But yeah. Right, guys, excuse the absolute state of me and excuse the Pringles can in the background. But anyway, I had a lot of fun filming all the videos today, as I did film three. This was just one of them. But I hope you enjoyed all the vlogs. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.